Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mexican President Felipe Calderon spoke to this House chamber last week as our guest. But I heard about it nonstop when I went back home to my district in Texas. My offices receive hundreds of calls, almost as many as those during the health care debate. To say my constituents were not happy with Calderon's speech would be an understatement. When I went out to get gas, go to a restaurant, or even wash my car, I got an animated earful from my neighbors. People in Southeast Texas thought he was disrespectful and ungrateful to America. My friend Sammy Mahan, who owns a wrecker service, said a lot of things, some of which I cannot repeat, but he did say, quote, Calderon lives in a lawless country and doesn't want the United States to enforce our laws either. It was like we invited a guest over for supper. He brought along all his friends and his family, complained about the food, griped about our neighborhood, then drove off in our pickup truck. Calderon spoke in Spanish directly to the Mexican nationals in America illegally, encouraging them to keep breaking our laws so they can send money back to Mexico. Remittances from the United States are Mexico's second largest source of foreign funds. Calderon told the illegals in Spanish right here in the People's House, right up here from this podium, quote, I want to tell the migrant to whom they are working here by the greatness of this country that we admire them, that we miss them, that we are fighting for their rights, and that we are working hard for Mexico and their families. He came across as encouraging defiance of American law. Exactly what are in America for the people in the United States illegally from Mexico? Would that be the so-called right to come here illegally, to work here illegally, and then send the money back to Mexico? That right doesn't exist, Mr. President. Would that be the right to illegally come to America, then demand citizenship? That right doesn't exist either, Mr. President. My constituents weren't very happy that the President of Mexico would come here as our guest, then arrogantly lecture the American people on what American laws he likes and which ones he doesn't like, then have the unmitigated nerve to blame Mexico's problems on America. Calderon said he doesn't like our right to keep and bear arms. Perhaps if Mexico honored the Second Amendment philosophy, the right to defend themselves, the people of Mexico wouldn't be held hostage by the drug cartels. He blamed America for the violence in Mexico. He blamed America for illegal guns going south and illegal immigration and drugs going north. Well, I have a solution for him. America should just seal the border frontier. We'll put the National Guard troops on the border to light up the criminal cartels. We've been protecting the borders of other nations like Iraq and Afghanistan and other places around the world. Our troops have been taking out the narco-terrorists worldwide. It's time we took care of business here at home, because the federal government has been AWOL at the border. And the people, the everyday Mexican people, are wonderful and hardworking people who love their own country. But their country is corrupt and cannot take care of them, or provide them safety, or jobs, or an education. So the people flee to the United States. Their own country has failed the people of Mexico. The people in Mexico are paying in blood and treasure for the lawlessness of the drug cartels. Instead of coming to America to tell us what laws we should and should not have, why not focus on making Mexico a place that the Mexican people aren't literally dying to leave? Mexicans risk rape, robbery, murder, and a horrible death by succumbing to the harsh desert elements when they try to come here illegally and cross the border. They're at the mercy of Mexico's criminal cartels. These people risk life and limb and are literally dying to leave Mexico, their native country. So instead of trying to balkanize America, President Calderon should concentrate on fixing his own problems instead of continuing to make Mexico's problems America's problems. They have the resources to build a country that will keep people in Mexico so they don't have to flee. The United States cannot and should not continue to be an ATM machine for Mexico and bail them out of their problems. President Calderon should deal with Mexico's issues and solve Mexico's economic problems, human rights problems, organized crime problems, violence problems, kidnapping problems, government corruption problems, illegal immigration problems, and the abandonment of Mexico by Mexicans before he lectures anybody about anything else. And that's just the way it is. I yield back.